God's conviction to his children is out of his kindness. We talked about the kindness of his conviction in a previous time together. But God's Holy Spirit's conviction is far different than the adversary's, which is one name for the devil, the adversary. He is our adversary. It's far different than the adversary's accusations. Now, how do you distinguish between the Holy Spirit convicting you out of his kindness, wanting you to experience his love and his joy and to bear fruit and experience his fellowship? How do you distinguish that from the adversary's accusation? I'm going to give you just a series of contrasts that I think collectively they have been a help to me. I'm not saying sometimes you also need people praying with you and praying for you and praying over you to distinguish this. I certainly do, because it's a spiritual battle. But I'd like you to just be able to observe these contrasts. Here is the first contrast. When the Holy Spirit convicts you, it will be clear and specific, as opposed to the adversary's accusation that will be vague. Now, I'm going to give you a series of contrasts, and collectively, I think they will help. That's one, clear and specific versus vague. Now, how do I know that? God tells me when he convicts me, he tells me to confess my sins. To confess is the word, the Greek word is to say the same thing. It's to agree with him. Okay, he will speak clear enough and specific enough that you can grab a hold of that, the heart that's willing to hear, to be able to agree and confess. So as opposed to vague, if there's just a sense, oh, you got a problem, you're just going to always have a problem, that's not the way God works. Seek him, saying, Lord, I trust you. I want to be in agreement with you. That's the key to joy. And so God, speak clear enough and specific enough that I can grab a hold of it. You can trust God for that. Another contrast is when the Holy Spirit's conviction are always helpful. He's out to help you. Remember, his conviction is not condemning you. He wants to help you. Help you, we talked about in a previous session, help you experience more of his joy and love and bear fruit, as opposed to the adversary's accusations are seeking to harass you. Helpful versus harass. I'll give you another contrast. The adversary's accusation promote despair. God's Holy Spirit's conviction are always hopeful. They're full of hope. See, God doesn't convict you of something without pointing you to a solution. Who wants to know of a problem if there's not a solution? But God points to a problem, a sin, but he says, look, there's a solution. There's something on the other side, as opposed to despair. God is a God of hope. The devil throws the fiery darts of despair at us. Another contrast is that Holy Spirit's conviction. Remember, Jesus described him as the Spirit of Truth. God's conviction are always going to be in harmony with the balanced teaching of Scripture, as opposed to the adversary, his accusations work in the realm of deceit, Not the Spirit of Truth, but the Spirit of deceit. Another contrast, and collectively, I think these things help. The Holy Spirit conviction is usually one thing at a time, as opposed to many things at once, just bombarding. You see, God has, I'm sure, many things he needs to do in my life. He's done a number of things, and I'm sure there's many more. Out of his great fatherly care, he doesn't raise everything at once. He, one thing at a time. You know, I remember a person about to conduct a retreat with a number of people that were in the Lord's work. And he said, look, if you walk away from this time together and you walk away with 10 things to do, you probably haven't heard God. If you walk away with one or two, you more likely heard God. That is the way God kindly works. I'll say one other contrast between the Holy Spirit's conviction and the adversary's accusation, and that is the fruit of it. When the Holy Spirit convicts and we respond, it gives you a freedom to love. It sort of unloads the burden off your back, as opposed to the adversary's accusation tend to put one, not a freedom to love, but put one in a bondage and fear of people. What a contrast. the freedom to love versus to love people versus the bondage and fear of people. The Holy Spirit's conviction is fine, is kind. We're in a battle. We're in a battle. And so I'm going to pray over you right now. And Lord, I pray for everyone in the hearing of my voice. God, would you send into their life the discernment they need? We ask you to, in the name and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, rebuke the accuser of the brethren. We pray you would silence the accuser's voice. We ask that you unleash the convicting work of your Spirit in every way we need it. Would you bless us by giving us the grace of repentance from what we need to be repented of? We love you, Lord. We pray that you would train us in this warfare and even use us as instruments to help others. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen.